Hey guys, welcome to another episode of What the Heck is Steve Talking About? Today, we're going to go over exercise 33. This is for Bill O'Neill's 401B class. And exercise 33 covers the direct current compound motor. So let's get started. Okay, so in our lab volt book, exercise 33, there are a couple pages for you to read through, of course. But when we get down to page 275 in exercise 33, they give us a wiring diagram. And as usual, I've already wired the trainer up, used my high-tech post-it notes to label a couple of wires. And I'm going to go ahead and take the readings for you that you are unable to because you're not here in the lab. And that's going to allow you to fill out this chart on page 276, and then that is going to lead to some answers for a graph that you need to fill out on page 277. So like I said, I've already wired this thing up, and the lab asks us to make a couple of preliminary settings, which I've done. I've set the voltage and the shunt field current at 0.4 amp. And so on this first reading, they want us to do it with no load. So we've got the belt taken off, and we just need to make sure that we're seeing 120 volts on our meter, and we are. I've got the shunt field set to 400 milliamps, and really it just wants an RPM reading off of the motor with no load. And I'm seeing 1800 RPM. And it wants armature current. And that is 0.3 amps or 300 milliamps. Okay, and now I'm going to put the belt back on to take the rest of these measurements. I won't make you suffer through that. So give me a minute and I'll be right back with you. Alright, so I've got the figures here on the chart for you, these first two columns. Of course, you need to do the math to figure out the rest of that. And ultimately, what these numbers are going to do is help you finish the graph on page 277. Okay? And ultimately, on the last page, there is that same question that we just went over in the previous chapter. And really, you guys should know the answer to this one by now. But on line 10, it's asking us to interchange the armature leads, 1 and 2. And really, it's in on line 12, it's asking us the rotational direction. Did it change? So if we turn the power on and increase the voltage a little bit, I think you can see it at the bottom of the screen. We were going clockwise for that lab, and I went ahead and changed the armature leads, and what happened now, we've reversed the motor direction. I think we've got that one down pretty well. Okay, so I will post the results here on my chart so you can do the rest of this. So once again, that's a short one. If you have any questions, my email address will be down below. Or as always, you can contact your instructor, Bill O'Neill. And I think that wraps it up. So there's another episode of What the Heck is Steve Talking About? Thanks for watching.